Hello and good day, people of all ages. This is Ian Fairley here, and for this channel, I am going to be educating you about dinosaurs. And in case you don't know what dinosaurs are, they are unique reptiles that walked on 2 feet like humans do, and walked on 4 feet like most modern animals. Dinosaurs have lived millions of years ago in an area known as the Mesozoic. Wow, that was a really long time before we existed. And in fact, there are various other creatures that have lived before human civilization. For example, small reptiles, small bugs, small mammals, small arachnids, and even small amphibians. And even small birds and sea creatures. Now, the Mesozoic era began from 250 million years ago, after the end of the Paleozoic era, and concluded 65 million years ago, before the beginning of the Cenozoic era, in which giant mammals took over the world. And there are three different time periods during the Mesozoic era: the Triassic period, the Jurassic period, and the Cretaceous period. Now, this all may be a bit shocking to you, but the dinosaurs might have died out because there was a giant asteroid the size or bigger than Mount Everest that crashed into the Earth 65 million years ago, wiping out almost the entire species of dinosaurs on the planet. Wow, an asteroid bigger than Mount Everest? That's crazy! Oh, and speaking of birds, did you know that they descended from dinosaurs? Kinda weird in a way, but most dinosaurs, as scientists say, possess feathers on their bodies, not for them to fly, but to keep them warm. So most dinosaurs will likely live in a sunny desert, but the environment around them will get really cold. That's why most dinosaurs need feathers. Just like we need jackets, even if there is no snow, our environment will more likely to be colder than ever. And now, without further ado, let's talk about two species of dinosaurs from the Late Cretaceous period, Tyrannosaurus Rex and Troodon. Let's start with Tyrannosaurus Rex, shall we? Now, some of you may have heard of this dinosaur, or maybe you haven't heard it at all, read it in books, watched it in movies. Now, all names have meanings, right? Tyrannosaurus Rex means Tyrant Lizard King. Oh, and just to be clear, if the name Tyrannosaurus Rex is too long for you to pronounce, you can just say T-Rex for short. Now, T-Rex was given that name because it was known to be an apex predator, like today's lions, tigers, and bears. This means that T-Rex was a predatory dinosaur that towered over its enemies and its prey. So basically, the only other thing T-Rex had feared was other T-Rexes like itself. While hunting other animals and scavenging for leftovers, T-Rex relied on its keen sense of smell, and like today's grizzly bears, T-Rex is able to sniff things from a mile away. Now, T-Rex's bones and fossil remains were found in 3 states of North America, including Montana, South Dakota, and Wyoming. T-Rex's bones were also discovered in the late 1800s.
Wow, that's about several years ago since paleontologist Barnum Brown gave T-Rex its name.
When the paleontologist reconstructed the T-Rex skeleton, it was estimated that T-Rex had to be 45 feet in length and 20 feet in height.
That's about as big as 1 or 2 elephants.
Now, we're not really sure how strong a T-Rex can bite because we've never seen it in person, but I have read a lot of books and it was inferred that T-Rex had a bite force of 7 tons of pressure. It's like a moving chainsaw cutting through a big tree. Those teeth are so sharp they can cut through 440 pounds of flesh, the size of a male lion. And furthermore, T-Rex was noticed to have tiny little arms on its body that weren't really much use for anything. But though its arms were 3 feet long, T-Rex used them for slashing prey at a close proximity to the dinosaur. And since T-Rex was a carnivore, its diet consisted of armored dinosaurs and duck-billed dinosaurs. T-Rex will most likely eat one of their own kind. That's called cannibalism. There are various animals that can eat each other: crocodiles, praying mantises, spiders, sharks,
well, etc., etc.
There have also been debates about whether T-Rex was a scavenger or a hunter. Well, since animals have a thing called high metabolism, that means they need to eat as much food as possible. Therefore, T-Rex was better off a hunter than a scavenger. There has also been other debates about whether T-Rex had feathers or not, just like today's birds. However, that theory has been proven to be false, since T-Rex lived in a sunny environment. But there are various relatives of T-Rex that possessed feathers on their bodies. I probably talked about T-Rex for too long, but now you know the facts about it. Let's move on to the Troodon. The Troodon's name means wounding tooth because it had small but sharp teeth. Troodon's teeth may have been sharp, but it looks similar of those to modern-day herbivorous reptiles, which is why Troodon was stated to be an omnivore, an animal that eats both plants and meat. It's just like saying wild pigs will eat plants most of the time, but at the same time, they will also eat meat.
Troodon's fossils were discovered in 1855 of Alberta, Canada, of North America. The dinosaur was estimated to be 3 feet in height and 6 feet in length, about the size of your pet dog, but twice as long.
However, paleontologists have discovered fossils of Troodon subspecies in Alaska, which were much bigger than the average Troodon. This may be due to them living in super cold environments, and these subspecies preferred meat over plants. There are two notable features that make Troodon different from other dinosaurs. For example, its eyes. Similar to modern-day owls, Troodons have possessed large, forward-facing eyes, allowing it to have good depth perception, meaning it could locate its prey from more than a foot away. This may have helped the Troodon hunt its prey, even at night, because Troodons have night vision and were known to be nocturnalists. Another feature that Troodon had was its large brain, making Troodon the most intelligent dinosaur species in the Cretaceous period and the world. I mean, he was not like the other dinosaurs. Troodon is very smart. Troodon may have used its brain for certain purposes. For example, like building nests out of sticks and leaves, or even using bugs as bait to catch fish, just like today's fishermen people. And those are all the facts about Troodon. This is Ian Fairley. Thank you for listening.